let us discuss the topic in biochemistry, that is chromatography. Chromatography. Basic definition of chromatography is, chromato means color and graphic means writing. This is normal definition of chromatography. Now in this lecture, let us discuss about first definition, second one classification, and next applications. Before discussing about definition, let us discuss one of the type of chromatographic method, that is first one, now let us consider this is a paper chromatographic method, and this is a paper. This is a paper, and it will act as inert substance. This paper will act as inert substance, and this paper is called Boltzmann paper. And there is a solvent which is present in this procedure. This is a solvent which is present in the procedure, and this solvent consists of three parts. One is butanol, acetic acid, and distilled water in the ratio of 4:1:5. This is a composition of solvent, that is butanol, acetic acid, and distilled water in the ratio of 4:1:5. Now, and this solvent also consists of amino acids like phenylalanine. This is one amino acid, that is phenylalanine, and this is another amino acid, that is let us consider alanine, and third amino acid, which is mixture of both of these phenylalanine and alanine. Now this is the basic structure of chromatography, and in this let us discuss two main important terminologies of this chromatography. First one is mobile phase. And other one is stationary phase. One is mobile phase and other one is stationary phase. Now coming to this diagram here, as we told that this solvent consists of butanol. Now this butanol will be turning over towards upside with the help of capillary pressure. Now, and this solvent consists of water. This water will get absorbed by this paper. Water will be absorbed onto the surface of this Boltzmann paper, and the amino acids which are highly soluble in these solvents, we move towards the larger side. Now the ammonia acids which are less soluble will go to the less distance when compared to this distance, and this mixed ammonia acids will go to only certain distance. In this way the separation can be done. And coming to this mobile phase and stationary phase, what is mobile phase? Mobile phase is a phase in which it moves from one phase to the another phase. Now in this diagram, the mobile phase is this butanol, and amino acids butanol and amino acids are the mobile phase in this diagram. And coming to the stationary phase, what is stationary phase in this diagram is the water which is absorbed on the surface of this filter paper. Water absorbed on surface of the filter paper. These are two phases. First one is mobile phase and second one is stationary phase. Mobile phase examples are here butanol and amino acids, and example here solvent. And stationary phase examples are the water which is absorbed at the underside of this filter paper. This is about paper chromatography. And if we discuss about next type of chromatography, that is column chromatography with aluminium coating. Let us consider this is a tube in which it is coated with aluminium. It is coated with aluminium, and at the inside of this aluminium, it consists of solute. This is a solute, black color and the solute which is present in this tube, and outside it is a solvent. Whenever the solvent is added into this tube, the highly soluble solvent will reach to this bottom layer, and the solvents which are less soluble in this solute will be reached up to here. And the solvents which are less soluble in the solute will reach only to this up to this certain area, and which are non soluble in this solute will remain in this area. In this way the separation can be done, and this is column chromatography with by using aluminium, and this is paper chromatography. With these examples, the definition can be given as chromatography is a method which is used for the separation of similar particles by continuous reabsorption of or redistribution of particles along mobile phase and stationary phase. Once again, the chromatography method is a method which is used for separation of similar particles by continuous redistribution of particles along the mobile phase and stationary phase is called chromatography. This is the definition. And coming to the classification, this classification of chromatography can be done by using two criteria. First one, based on mobile phase. Classification of chromatography based on mobile phase can be classified into two forms. One is liquid chromatography and other one is gaseous chromatography. One is liquid chromatography and other one is gaseous chromatography. By using mobile phase, what is liquid chromatography means, whenever the mobile phase is in liquid form, it is called liquid chromatography, and whenever the mobile phase is in gaseous form, then it is called as gaseous chromatography. This is about mobile phase. And second criteria is based on stationary phase. First one, this is mobile phase and this is stationary phase. In stationary phase, chromatography is again classified into two forms. One is liquid form, other one is gaseous form. And this liquid and gaseous again internally subdivided into two divisions. One is solid, other one is liquid. And here same, it is solid and it is liquid. And this is classification based on stationary phase. That is, based on stationary phase, chromatography is divided into two forms. One is liquid form and other one is gaseous form. And this liquid form internally transferred into solid form and liquid form, and this gaseous form again divided into solid form and liquid form. And here it can again classify into liquid solid, so that is solid liquid chromatography, and here liquid liquid chromatography, and this is solid gaseous chromatography and liquid gaseous chromatography. Now, based on stationary phase, it is divided into liquid and gaseous, and this liquid is divided into solid and liquid, and gaseous is divided into solid and liquid. And it is internally again divided into solid liquid chromatography, liquid liquid chromatography, and solid gaseous chromatography, and liquid gaseous chromatography. And examples for this solid chromatography is aluminium, that is by using aluminium. And liquid chromatography is this paper chromatography. Here also same, that is aluminium and liquid chromatography. And this is about classifications of chromatography. And this chromatography is primarily depend on five factors. This chromatography, the steps of this chromatography is mainly dependent on five criteria. That is, first criteria is adsorption. and second criteria is partition. And the third criteria is molecular sieving. And the fourth criteria is ion exchange. And the fifth criteria is affinity. These are the five criteria on which this chromatography is dependent. First one is adsorption, second one is partition, and third one is molecular sieving, fourth one is ion exchange, and fifth one is affinity. Now, this adsorption example is paper chromatography. Paper chromatography in which water is adsorbed on the surface of this paper, that is filter paper, Waksman filter paper. This is first criteria, that is adsorption, and second one is partition. This partition is mainly dependent on solubility. Now, the solvent which is highly soluble will be going to the top side, or in this case, the highly soluble material will be coming towards downside, and less solubility will be remained at lower side, and here less solubility will be remained at higher side. In this way, it is dependent on solubility, that is second portion, second factor, that is partition. And next one is molecular sieving. What is molecular sieving? In case of molecular sieving, here in case of aluminium, we use gel. Aluminium is replaced by gel, and in this gel, it consists of special pores, pore-like structures. These are the special pore-like structures inside the gel, and it helps in traveling of this solvent molecules towards the downside, and it is based on size. The large size solvent molecules can move easily towards this side, and the low size or small size of solvent particles will get stuck in this pores. This is molecular sieving. Next one is ion exchange method. This ion exchange method is based on charges. It is based on charges, that is positive and negative. It is based on positive charges and negative charges. Next one is affinity. It is based on affinity. These are the five characters which involves in chromatography, that is adsorption, partition, molecular sieving, ion exchange, and affinity. And the applications are, it is used in separations. This is about chromatographic method.